Meantime, President Trump set to take off from the White House about an hour from now amid his budding feud with the state's Democratic governor, Andrew Cuomo. The two going back and forth after Cuomo took a swipe at the president during a speech this week. New York's Republican Party weighed in, tweeting a picture of a bus ticket, saying taxpayers chipped in to buy Cuomo a $55 one-way bus ticket to Canada. Off to Montreal he goes. This bringing New York Congressman Lee Zeldin. Sir, good morning to you. Tongue in cheek there, a little bit of humor.
Good morning.
Here is what the governor said 2 days ago. Listen here, we'll get your reaction.
We're not going to make America great again. It was never that great.
Well, we heard the reaction from the crowd. What's your reaction, sir?
America is the greatest, most exceptional nation in the history of this world. I could think of all different kinds of reasons why over the course of time, from the founding of our country, the putting a man on the moon, the liberation of Jews from concentration camps, the advancements of science and medicine. We have the greatest military in the world, the largest economy, and the freedoms and liberties that make people come to our country, pouring over our borders, trying to get here to live and be part of what is American greatness and pursue the American dream. For this governor, I mean, I'll tell you, you would have to torture me to get me to say what this governor said, and he said it so easily. I would say this, there's a lot of hypocrisy out there of people who always like to take President Trump's words and cast them in the worst possible light, who are now tripping over themselves saying what he meant to say. Let's just take what he said literally, and the reality that his reaction afterwards wasn't to clarify his own remarks. He actually doubled down and went on offense and made some ridiculous comment about how, you know, Donald Trump wants America to be great with the KKK. Like, it's insane. And this guy is a governor who wants to be president, but I think he wants to be president of the wrong country because we're not electing him.
He's running for re-election. Guys, skip forward once to get the Cuomo tweet. Here's what you're referring to, okay? Then I'll show you the tweet from the West Wing. At Real Donald Trump, he said, "What you say would be great again would not be great at all. We would not go back to discrimination, segregation, sexism, isolation, racism, or the KKK. That's what you're referring to. Here's what the president said. He said, "How does a politician, Cuomo, known for pushing people and businesses out of the state, not to mention having the highest taxes in the U.S., survive making the statement, 'We're not going to make America great again. It was never that great.' Which section of the sentence is worse?" You pick it.
I mean, there's, you know, I have nothing wrong with what Donald Trump, what President Trump is saying is absolutely true, because up in Albany, Andrew Cuomo feels like his work is done here as far as making our government operate more efficiently with our taxes, our spending. We spend over $1 billion a week just on Medicaid alone. What you're seeing now, people leaving our state, going to North Carolina, South Carolina, and Florida, and we need people who are representing us. I'm a New Yorker, representing us up in Albany, who feel like that their toughest work is still ahead to make our state operate more efficiently, to improve the business climate, to make easier for young families to start their families here, to make it easier for families, seniors, to be able to afford to stay. For Andrew Cuomo, instead of using that opportunity with a clarifying tweet to say on his own what he meant to say, instead he goes on offense. No one is saying that we should make America great again by, you know, ridiculousness with, like, supporting the KKK. That's insane. And what we want to do is continue to see our economy improve. Right now we're seeing that there are more available jobs than people to fill them. Unemployment at historic lows. Markets and 401ks at historic highs. The president's coming to my district here in an hour or two. I'm looking forward to seeing him and saying thank you for all of your help to defeat MS-13, to help grow our economy, to better secure our borders, to strengthen our military, improve our foreign policy, and to make countries respect us again. Adversaries understanding that they do not respect weakness, they only respect strength. So I'm looking forward for the president coming to my district to let him know about the hundreds.
We'll see what happens at Cuomo's reelection based on this comment here. But you mentioned it. You gave a long pitch there. Your message to the president's pretty obvious. How is the economy doing in your district? You've got a reelection in less than 3 months. Got about 20 seconds on that. Got to roll.
I live in Suffolk County. Our unemployment rates are hitting historic lows in our home county. So we're seeing it all across the country. We're feeling good. There's more work to do, but we want to work together across party lines to try to get further progress and fight past this obstruction, those who want to impeach, oppose, obstruct. That's not the path forward, the best path forward for America.
Lee Zeldin, the Republican from New York. He's coming your way. We'll follow it today in about an hour's time. Thank you, sir, for being here. We'll speak again.
Thank you, Bill.
All right.